Good morning, students. This is the class for 7th standard science subject and physics. Our class for science measurement. Okay, students. On paper, we have seen physical quantities, and physical quantities divided into two types of fundamental quantities, derived quantities. Then we have seen the fundamental quantities, different types of fundamental quantities, and units and symbols also. Okay. Then what we have seen on that day, derived quantities. Okay, derived quantities, some derived quantities and the units symbol also. Okay. So today what we are going to see about this is the remaining two. Okay, the remaining two derived quantities and the units and the formula. Okay. So first, the fourth derived quantity is electric charge. Okay, electric charge. Electric charge is nothing but okay. Charge means electrons. The withdrawal of electron from one place to another place, or left side to right side, or lower place to higher place. Okay, charge means electrons. Charge means electrons. Okay, students. So what is the formula for electric charge? The amount of current passing through the circuit that is divided by the time taken. Okay, the amount of electric current is passing through the circuit that is divided by the time taken is nothing but electric charge. The SI unit of electric charge is coulomb per second. That is the SI unit for electric current. Okay, is coulomb. Okay, so that is divided by time. The SI unit for time is second. So coulomb divided by second is the unit for electric charge. Okay, the next one is density. Next one is density. What is the formula for density? Mass by volume. Okay, mass by volume. So the unit for density is kilogram by meter cube. How? The SI unit for mass is kilogram and the SI unit of volume is meter cube. So that the density, so that the SI unit for density is kilogram by meter cube. Okay, students. Then our next topic is area of some regularly shaped figures. Okay, some regularly shaped figure means what? Square, rectangle, circle, triangle. Okay, so like that they are called as regularly shaped figure. Regularly shaped figure, we have to give the formula. Okay, we have to give the formula. So first one is square. The diagram of a square is this. All sides, four sides of the square. Okay, four sides of the square are same. Okay, four sides of the square are same. So the area, the formula for area, okay, is side into side. So one side is A, another side is A. So the formula for A is A into A is equal to A square. Okay, A into A is equal to A square. Second one is rectangle. What is the shape of rectangle? You know, already studied in your maths class. Okay, what is the shape of the rectangle? This is. Okay, so this one is, this base is called as length, and this a short line is called as, okay, short of line is called as breadth. Okay, this long time line is called as length. Okay, so what is the formula for rectangle? What is the area formula for rectangle? Length into breadth. So that we can write L into B, that is equal to LB, that means length into breadth. Okay, then third one, figure is circle. You know the shape of the circle? Yes, round circle. Okay, here the center of the circle, here edge of the circle is called as radius. Okay, center of the circle to the edge of the circle is called as radius. So what is the area formula of a circle? Pi r square, because this one is radius and this one is another radius. So pi r square, so that is equal to pi r square. What is the formula for area of the circle? Pi r square. The last one is triangle. You know the shape of the triangle? Yes. So this is the shape of the triangle. This underline, okay, under the line is called as base. This one is lengthy, line is called as height. So the formula for triangle is half into base into height. Half into base into height. Okay, students. Then move on to the next topic is our problems. Okay. In previous section we have seen the formula. So by using the formula we have to do the problems now. Okay. So first, the problem is, what is the area of an 10 squares? What is the area of an 10 squares? Each side of 1 meter. Students, here one point is that, what is that? Squares means all sides, 4 sides are same. Squares means 4 sides are same. So, area of a square, we know that formula, area of a square is equal to side into side. So, here we take 1 square means all sides of 1 meter. So, the formula for square is a into a. So, that is equal to 1 into 1 is equal to 1 meter square. Because here 1 meter, here 1 meter. So, it becomes meter square. But our problem is area of 10 squares. Okay, area of 1 square is 1 meter square means area of 10 square is what? So, 1 into 10 is equal to 10 meter square. Okay, students? 1 into 10 is equal to 10 meters square. Then move on to the second problem. Find the area of the following regular shaped figures. Okay, find the area of the following regularly shaped figures. Regular shaped figure means what? Rectangle, square, circle, triangle. Okay, so first submission is a rectangle whose length is 12 meter and the breadth is 4 meter. Okay, a rectangle. We have to draw the one rectangle whose length is what? This is the length, this is the breadth. Okay, lengthy line is called as length, short line is called as breadth. Okay, students, so here the length is equal to 12 meter and breadth is equal to 4 meter. Okay, lengthy line is called as length, shorter line is called as breadth. Here length is equal to 12 meter, breadth is equal to 4 meter. So we know the formula. What is the area formula for rectangle? Length into breadth. So 12 into 4 is equal to 48 meters square. The unit of this is meter square. Okay, students, unit for area is what? Meter square. Okay, students, the next submission B is a circle whose radius is 7 meter. Whose radius is 7 meter. So we have to draw one circle whose radius is 7. Okay, we know the area formula for circle is pi r square. So pi, they are given the pi value in the question itself. Okay, pi is equal to 22/7. So we have to put instead of pi 22/7 into here the radius is 7. So formula is r square. So 7 into 7. So these 7 denominator 7 and numerator 7 will be cancelled. The remaining part is 22 into 7, it becomes 154 meters square. Okay, 154 meters square. Then third submission is a triangle whose base is 6 meter and the height is 8 meter. Okay, so we have to draw one triangle whose base, this is the height. Okay, so height is 8 meter and base is 6 meter. We know the area formula for triangle, but it is a half into base into height. So half into base 6 meter into height is 8 meter. Okay, here 1 2s are 2, 3 2s are 6. So it will be cancelled. The remaining part is 3 heights are 22 meters square. Okay, students, understand the problem? Then move on to the next topic is area of irregularly shaped figures. Okay, area of irregularly shaped figures. Irregularly shaped figure means we know the shape of the figure, that is square, rectangle, triangle, circle. Okay, irregularly means what? Irregularly, leaves, then flowers, then shape of stickers of the stars, then peak of feathers, okay, etc. These are called irregularly shaped figures. Here we have to calculate the area of irregularly shaped figure means what we have to use? We have to use the graph sheet. Okay, by using of the graph sheet we have to find the irregularly shaped figures area. Okay, students, first you take the graph sheet, then take the leaves of any trees. Okay, any trees or any plants that put on the graph sheet, you have to draw the shape of the leaves in the graph sheet. Then you leave the leaves. Okay, then you have to calculate the squares. Okay, inside the leaves you have to calculate the squares. Okay, so from that we have to calculate the area of the leaves. Okay, they have the leaves, our flowers, our peacock feathers, etc. Okay, students. Then our next topic is value. Value means bar, the amount of space by space occupied by an object. Okay, so object kula, things kula, material kula, how much amount of space is occupied? Okay, that is called as volume. Okay, so what is the formula for volume? It becomes area into height. We know that area height means easily we can calculate the volume. How? What is the formula for area? Area is equal to length into breadth. So we have to find the volume means what are the things we have to know. First one is length, second one is breadth, and third one is height. These three are easily calculated means the volume can be easily calculated. Okay, so the SI unit of volume is meter cube. How? The SI unit for length is meter, breadth also meter, and the height also meter. So meter into meter, meter is equal to meter cube. So the SI unit of volume is meter cube. Okay, this is for solid things, that is bricks. We have to calculate the volume of the bricks, stones. Okay, we have to calculate the volume of solid item means we have to use the formula meter cube. Okay, for calculate the liquid item means, for example, we have to calculate the oil, volume of oil or volume of water or volume of juice means we have to use the SI unit of liter. Okay, this one is liter, one is used for liquid items, and a meter cube, centimeter cube, centiculum is used for solid items. Okay, so 1000 milliliter is equal to 1 liter. 1000 milliliter is equal to 1 liter. This is used for liquid items. Okay, then 1 liter is equal to 1000 centiculum. 1 liter is equal to 1000 centiculum or centimeter cube. This is used for solid items. Okay, students, understand? Okay, thank you, students.